Good morning, students. In our previous video, we have discussed till question number 5 of exercise 5.3. So today we will discuss the rest question of this exercise, and then after we will start our new topic, that is scientific notation. So let's first discuss the question number 7 of this exercise. In question number 7, they have given, if PQ, its value is given 3 by 5 whole power 3 and power of power is 5. Then after they have given multiply 10 by 9 whole power 5 and power of power is 3. And from here we have to find out the value of PQ plus Q upon P. Let's cross check again. 3 by 5 cube power of power 5, 10 by 9 whole cube whole power 5 and cube. So now listen, students, how to solve this one. So first of all, we have to solve this value of PQ, and from here we have to find this PQ. So let's start this one. If we solve this one, 5 3 is 15. 3 by 5 power of power is 15. So students, if we solve here, 10 by 9, okay, and 5 3 is 15. Power of power is 15. Now students, here we know the rules. If the base are different and power are same, then what we will do? We will multiply. How we will multiply here? This one, 3 by 5 multiplied 10 by 9 and power is 15. Okay students, 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 3 1 is 3, 3 3 is 9. So students, here we can write 2 by 3 whole power 15, and in another way we can write 2 power 15 and 3 power 15. This is the value of P by Q. So let's write the value here, P by Q. So P upon Q, P value is 2 power 15 and 3 power 15 plus Q value 3 raised to the power 15 and 2 raised to the power 15. Okay students, now then after we take the LCM, LCM if we will take, this will be multiplied 3 to the 6 whole power 15. How? Because find the LCM, we multiply 3 power 15 and 2 power 15. Power same, then base multiply 3 to the 6, 6 raised to the power 15. Then after 3 to the 6 raised to the power 15 plus 3 to the 6 raised to the power 15. How I, sorry, 3 3 is the, wait, here we done some mistake. This 3, then 2 2 is 4 raised to the power 15 and 3 3 is 9 raised to the power 15. Now students, this is the solution of this question. Then we get from here 4 raised to the power 15 and plus 9 raised to the power 15. Okay students, so this is our question number 7 of exercise 5.3. Now let's start the question number 8. In question number 8, they have given, we have to express the following situation, whatever they have given an equation, in the form of as a power of 4. So how to write this one? Let's see. I'm going to solve its first part. In first part, they have given 18 raised to the power 2 multiply 1 by 18 raised to the power 2. Let's solve this one, because this is the 18 square multiply 1 by 18 square. Okay friends, this is cancelled. From here we will get the answer 1. And friends, we have to convert this one as a notation. We have to convert this one as a power of 4. So students, if we write here 4 raised to the power 0, then also it's correct? Yes. Because if any base whose power is 0, that equals to 1. That equals to 1. So that's why here we can express this one as a 4 raised to the power 0. And this is our final answer. Now we have converted this one as a power of 4. So let's make you more clear. I am going to solve one more part from this exercise. Let's take a second part. In second part they have given minus 19 raised to the power 2 multiply minus 19 raised to the power 4, bracket close, and then after they have given divide by minus 19 raised to the power 6. Okay students, same base, power different, then power will be plus. 2 plus 4 6, divide minus 9 power 6. So if we divide the same base, then power will be subtract, and here we will get minus 19 power 0, that's mean 1. And same situation we get if the answer is 1. How can we write this in another form? 4 raised to the power 0. Okay students, so same situation we get if we get the answer 1, and when we can write as a 4 raised to the power 0. Students, why we are writing here 4 raised to the power 0? Because in question they have given clearly, he expressed the answer as a power of 4. So here the power of 4 is 0, and this is our answer. Okay students, understood this one? Now, then after let's take one more part, that is part number 6 from this one. In this question they have given 5 raised to the power 0 plus 7 raised to the power 0. Then after divide 2 raised to the power 0 plus 3 raised to the power 0. 5 power 0, 1. 7, 0, 1. Divide 2 raised to the power 0, 1, and 3 raised to the power 0, 1. 2 divided by 2, that means answer is 1. Same situation, 1 we can write as a 4 raised to the power 0 as a power of 4. Okay, understood this one? Now let's start our new topic, that is scientific notation. Okay students, so now we are going to start our new topic, that is scientific notation. And scientific notations they have given in the form of expanded form. Okay, that means a full form, a simple question is given, and we have to write that question in standard form. How? Let's see. First, I'm going to explain with the help of one example. That is, here the topic is scientific notation. Scientific notation. Now I have the question 149 600, then 30 and 30. Okay, the number is written 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, 1,000,000, 10,000,000, 100,000,000, 1,000,000,000, 10,000,000,000, 100,000,000. So 149,600,000,000. And we have to convert this one as a scientific notation. How we convert? Student, if we are going to write this question, so how to convert this one? For this, before this one, I want to explain one thing. If any number, for example, 4.96 multiply by 100, what answer we get from here? Simply, according to the decimal, the shift to the right side, two digits, so 20. We can write this number 496. So since as like this question, we will take this multiple of 10 from here, that zeros from here. How? I can say a number in the form of k, a number in the form of k and multiple power of 10 is called as a scientific notation. So we have to convert this number according to this formula. So here k can be students any number from 1 to 10. K can be any number 1 to 10. So how to write this one? First count the digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Students, here we have to leave the k. So here we will write 1. And then after, according to the digit, we will put decimal. Then we will write 4, 9, 6, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, 0. So, and if we put decimal here after the first digit, then count the digit after given this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, here we can write 10 raised to the power 11. Or after the decimal, it's a no need to write to this much 0. In short form, we can write 1.496 multiplied 10 raised to the power 11. Students, now we have written this question as a scientific notation. So this form is called as scientific notation. Okay, students. So let's, might be understood. Let's take one more question to explain you more. That is another part. Okay. I'm going to explain this one with the help of one more. That is, I'm going to take the question from exercise. Exercise 5.4, question number first. Express the following in scientific notation. They have given 892. Okay. Then after 30, again 30, and again 30. That means they have given 892 billion. Okay, students. Now then after I told, you put the decimal after first digit. So after 8, I put the decimal. 8, 9, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. So according to the digit after this decimal, we will take the power of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So here the 10 raised to the power 11. So we have to write in the form of k multiplied 10 raised to the power m. So k is r, this number, and 10, this one. So after decimal, no need to write that much zeros. So simply we can write 8.92, 10 raised to the power 11. Let's take one more part to make you more clear. I'm taking its sixth part. In sixth part, they have given 3 crore, 18 lakh, 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000 lakh, 10 lakh crore, 10 crore and Arab. So we can write here, we have to put the decimal after 3. After 3, we put the decimal and write the digit as it is after. And the power of 10 according to the number of digits after decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 10 raised to the power 9. Or in another way, we can write 3.1865. multiplied 10 raised to the power 9. Now students, we have written this one in scientific notation, and the other name of scientific notation is in standard form, but usually we are using the word scientific notation. So let's discuss its second part, second question. Second question they have already given to us in scientific notation, and we have to convert that number in standard form. So let's try the first question. Question number second, express in usual form. So we have to convert in usual form, and the number is given 2.38 multiply 10 raised to the power 8. Students, as I told you, 10 raised to the power 8 means after decimal, that means 8 digits should be there. So if you will write, the decimal will shift till 8 digit after the decimal. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we have written this question in usual form. How? Because the decimal was here, and we know very well this power will come whatever the number of digit after decimal. So I can explain this one in another way also. Here we can write this way, 2.38 multiply 10 raised to the power 8. That means after 180, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And whenever any number multiply like this with a multiple of 10, 100,000, the decimal shift to the right side according to the number of digits. So here are 8 digits. So decimal after shift 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The decimal will be here. So this is our usual form of the given number. Okay, students? And if you put the decimal, we can put the decimal like this. Okay, 23,80,000. ओके नो सॉरी 23,80,00,000. लेट्स टेक वन मोर एग्जाम, वन मोर पार्ट ऑफ दिस वन टू मेक यू मोर क्लियर. 2.394 मल्टीप्लाई 10 रेज टू द पावर 4. दैट्स मीन वी कैन राइट 2.394 मल्टीप्लाई 1 आफ्टर 40, बिकॉज 10 रेज टू द पावर 4, दैट्स मीन 1 आफ्टर 40. सो दिस डेसिमल शिफ्ट टू द 4 डिजिट. सो यू विल राइट 1, 2, 3 1, 2, 3 and 4 डेसिमल शिफ्ट हियर, बिकॉज 4 डिजिट 1, 2, 3, 4 1, 2, 3, 4. स्टूडेंट्स इफ एनी डिजिट इज नॉट देयर सिंपली वी आर राइटिंग देयर 0. सो नाउ वी हैव रिटर्न दिस साइंटिफिक नोटेशन इन यूजुअल फॉर्म. ओके नाउ लेट्स टेक इट्स क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ऑल्सो दे हैव गिवन इन फॉर्म ऑफ स्टेटमेंट एंड दैट स्टेटमेंट क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट इन साइंटिफिक नोटेशन. ओके सो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन 1 or 2 पार्ट फ्रॉम दिस एंड द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ यू हैव टू डू. Question number three. First part I'm taking. The distance between Earth and Moon. The distance between Earth and Moon. The distance is given 384, then after 30 and 30. So simply we can read this one. 1, 10, 100,000, 10,000, 100,000, 1,000,000, 10,000,000, 100,000,000. 384 million meters. So we have to convert this one in scientific notation. So students, as I told, after the first digit, we put decimal. Okay? And write the after digit as it is. And count the digit after the first digit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here we can write 10 raised to the power 8. And simply we can write 3.84 multiply 10 raised to the power 8. Because after decimal, if the zeros are there at the end, so we can skip that zeros and directly we can write 3.84. And we count the digit after this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. According to that only we write the power of 10. Okay students, and now today we have complete our chapter, that is chapter number 5, and then after there is a one miscellaneous exercise. Miscellaneous exercise means the overall brief of chapter, means in this miscellaneous exercise they include all type of the questions that we have discussed in whole chapter. So student, this miscellaneous exercise also you have to solve. Okay, but no need to solve in practice in register. You can solve in your rough notebook. Okay students, and then after they have given a MCQs exercise also, that is multiple choice question, that exercise also you will solve in your book.